Hey everybody, welcome in. My name is Ernest and I'm going to teach you how to cook. Today on the show, I can't imagine anybody not loving this dish. It is pork chops and applesauce. I'm going to show you how to take regular bone-in seared pork chops, smother them in a wonderful mushroom gravy, bake them up, and they're going to be tender and delicious. In the extra helping, stay tuned because I am a guy that loves his cinnamon applesauce, and when I figured out how to make it on my own, I never bought store-bought again. Let's get going. This is just like one of my favorite all-time meals. This is eating in bed. You know, like I said in the intro, if you've ever watched that Brady Bunch episode, you've seen Peter Brady talk about pork chops and applesauce.
Wash for dinner.
Pork chops.
Pork chops. Huh? What else?
Applesauce?
Pork chops and applesauce. Ain't that swell?
And growing up, my mother made that. She also made black-eyed peas with it. Now, the black-eyed peas, let me tell you about those real quick before we get to the pork chops. Take a bag of black-eyed peas, just a little 1 pound bag, and you're going to soak it in water like you do beans, like we did last week. But what I want you to do is boil enough water that will cover the beans a couple of inches. Bring the water to a boil, put the beans in a bowl, and then pour the hot water over it and just let it set on the counter. This will kind of expedite the soaking and puffing up process, and it will take maybe 2 to 2.5 hours, and those peas will be ready to go. Drain them off, rinse them, put them in a nice big Dutch oven, like a 5-quart Dutch oven, put a chopped onion in it, put the tiniest bit of salt and pepper, you can put a little herb like some rosemary or something like that in it, cover it, put it in a 350-degree oven for 90 minutes. They don't take long at all compared to something like pinto beans or kidney beans. When they're done, give them a taste and then add any extra seasoning you want. You can add a little garlic powder, a little onion powder to it, you know. Just check them after 90 minutes. They should be nice and firm, but you can still bite into them with no, you know, hardness or al dente in them. They shouldn't be mushy like green peas. They should have a little bit more body to them like red beans or pinto beans. So we're gonna do that. We've already got that done, but here we're making smothered pork chops. Now I have some really nice chops over here. I've already cooked some up. These are really nice big chops. They've got a little bit of a bone in them. They've got some fat on the side, but that's okay. I've already cooked some of them up, as you can see here. Let me show you real quick. I've already cooked some of them up. I've seared them on either side about 2 to 2.5 minutes over a medium heat with a little bit of olive oil in the pan, a little bit of salt and pepper on either side. They're not totally done. You're really just kind of searing the outside. I've oiled the bottom of my dish here. This is a pretty big dish. This is one size bigger than the 9 by 13. It's probably 11 by 14 because I have a lot of chops. There's 5 big chops here. So I've seared 3 of these off, and the pan has some fond in the bottom of it, which is the, you know, the char or whatever from the pork chop. So I'm over kind of a medium to low heat. You don't want to go too fast on these. There's a little salt and pepper on both sides of these. And you're really just going to let these cook for about 2 minutes on either side. Now, I know at some point you're going to be tempted to move these around, but don't. I have my tongs handy, but you just want these to sear a little bit. Now, what we're gonna do with the fond that's left over in here, we're gonna make ourselves a really nice sauce from this. Now, you can make a white bechamel sauce. We've done it before, where you use a little flour, a little butter, put some heavy cream in it, let it thicken up, and then you start adding flavors to it. We've done it a lot for mac and cheese and for other things. I'm taking a little bit of a shortcut today. Let me show you what we're gonna use first. I have one larger container of these little brown mushrooms. I think it's like an 8 or 9 ounce package. I just pulled the stems out of them, sliced them really thin. We're gonna saute these down in a minute. I also have one large white onion or two small white onions if you want. This is gonna be part of our sauce as well. I also have a little bit of Worcestershire sauce I'm going to use for this. Adds that little bit of extra meaty, hearty flavor to it. And lastly, I haven't finished mixing this yet. This is 2 cans of cream of mushroom soup. Now, I know your mom might have used this. Like I said, you can make your own bechamel sauce and make a mushroom sauce with it for this. I'm going a little shorter. So I got 2 cans of the condensed mushroom soup and 1 can of 2% milk. You can use heavy cream if you want to, or any kind of milk really. But I figured 2% or 1% is just right good in the medium. I got a little bit of salt, maybe a quarter teaspoon of salt, not a lot, and about a half a teaspoon of black pepper on here. I'm just gonna finish stirring it in and set that aside. When this is done, we're gonna use the drippings in the pan to create our sauce and then slather it over everything and let it bake. Preheat your oven to 325 degrees. We're going in a little bit cooler oven. Usually 350 is that good middle mark where you can roast up anything and bake anything. But we're gonna do 325 because I told you before that as you cook protein, if you cook it too fast, it can get really tough. It happens with eggs, it happens with chicken, with beef. If you've ever had those wonderful ribs that just fall apart, that's because they're slow cooked. So we're going to slow cook it at 325. Now we're just searing these. They're still really raw in the middle. We're just getting a little bit of char. See, it's got a little bit of caramelization, a little bit of cooking on it. Just a couple minutes on either side. And then we're just gonna get this sauce going real quick. It's gonna be really tasty. I always love that little piece right there that hangs off the side. There's some that are already in the pan and I used to just take this off. That's like meat candy right there, right? So delicious. It smells good just as it is. You can smell the pork, you can smell the salt and pepper. It's the simplest of things that always come out the most tasty, I think. Okay, I think these pork chops are about done, so I'm gonna go ahead and pull them out and just put them into my baking dish off to the side here. Try not to layer them directly on top of each other. If a couple of ends kind of fold over a little bit, that's fine, but don't stack them on each other. Get a bigger pan or use 2 smaller pans to lay this out in here. I'll show it to you when we're done here. Now, here's the pan. I got a little bit of fond in there. That's what you call the stuff on the bottom. And there's a lot of flavor in that. So I'm gonna keep my heat on low. I've got about 1/2 cup of white wine, just any good white wine that you would drink. I'm gonna use about 1/2 of that, about 1/4 cup just to start here. Actually, I'm gonna pull the heat up ever so slightly to get this going. And this is called deglazing the pan. When you put that in here and you use a spatula or really a wooden spoon is best, you can start pulling up those bits off of the bottom. You see how it's coming up right there? See where my spoon is pointing? See, you got fond right there and then you've got it pulled up right there. So whenever you're doing, you know, like a beef or chicken or something like that, sometimes you may get a little bit more on the bottom of the pan than not. Okay, so I've got a lot of that pulled up. I'm gonna go ahead in this pan, keeping your temperature a little higher. I'm gonna put the onions right in here. Now, a lot of people might put the onions in with a little bit more butter or oil, but I want them to actually kind of blanch a little bit or almost braise in a way in this white wine. Then we're gonna add our mushroom sauce right at the end. So I'm gonna put all the mushrooms and all the onions right in there. Bring it up to temperature. Using my tongs, I'm gonna start tossing these around. And remember, mushroom and onion have a lot of water in them. They're like 85, 90% water. So when this really starts to cook down, the flavors are gonna start to blend and meld together, and it's really gonna be a delicious sauce. And you could just leave it like that, but I wanted something a little creamy like my mom used to do. So that's why I'm going to use the mushroom soup mix with a little bit of salt and pepper and milk in it. Let me show you how I put together the pork chops. I'm just going to set them here real quick. I just layered them out. They're overlapping a little bit, but I've got one of the bigger pans that's an 11 by 14 or so, or 15, and I've got them spread out pretty well over here on their own. They're just slightly going. If you really wanted, you could cut that piece off and put it someplace else. This is good the way it is. We're just going to put that sauce all over it when it's done and then put it in the oven. So we'll put this back off to the side. Because we salt and pepper the pork chops, I'm not going to add any more salt or pepper to this pan right now. I'm really just gonna let this cook for a little bit, get it where it needs to be, and then I'll make a judgment after that. And you know, we've got salt and pepper in the mushroom sauce as well, so. So this is going to cook about 6 or 7 minutes. You want these to cook down a bit. You don't want them to totally caramelize and just lose everything about them, but you want them to cook down a little bit, get a little soft, start to release their water. Make sure everything's broken up here really well. Sometimes I don't slice all the way through like I should. Just kind of keep that going. So it's been about 6 or 7 minutes, and as you can see, it's really reduced down. This is really cooked down. You want a lot of that wine just to cook off. You're going to get that great flavor, but you don't want this real runny or juicy or anything. So we're done with that. Now I've got a spatula here and the soup mix. We're going to pour this right in. We're basically just going to be warming this up is what we're doing, and get those onions and mushrooms incorporated. And then we're going to get it in the pan. This already looks so good, you guys. Okay, so I'm still over a medium high heat. I want to keep this going. This has been at room temperature, but it had some cool milk in it and everything. So kind of pulling this together here. Just like that. Oh God, those caramel. When onions start to cook down like that, they give off just that wonderful sweet scent, but they're also a little bit savory. So it's just, oh, I love that smell. Raw onion, not so much. Cooked onion, yeah. At this point, I am gonna put in just a little bit of Worcestershire sauce. Not a whole lot, maybe a teaspoon or so. Not too much. When it cooks down, you don't want it to get real salty or anything like that. So take this off the heat. We don't need to boil it or anything like that. Let's put it on the pork chops. So here's my pan of pork chops. They're nice and laid out. We've seared them. You know, we've just left them at room temperature while we're cooking those mushrooms and onions. Here's the pan, and I'm just going to evenly get this on top of everything. All over. Use a spatula and get every bit of that out of your pan. It's worth it. So we're just gonna push this all around. Just make sure everything's covered. Well, just like that. Okay. 325 oven, about 45 minutes or so. Leave it uncovered. Check them every once in a while. Just make sure nothing's bubbling over or burning. It shouldn't at that lower temperature. I'll see you on the other side. Stay tuned, because after the break, we're gonna be making cinnamon applesauce. You don't wanna miss it. It's just that good. And I'm gonna have some black eyed peas too. So stay tuned, I'll see you right after this.
Oh, stop! Don't you dare spend your money until you get Doc Rock lowest price guarantees on car audio, home audio, VCRs, and TVs.
Telephone with answering machine, $49. Two-way home speakers, $10. AM FM cassette in dash, $29. 19-inch color remote control, $289.
Visa, MasterCard, American Express, or Instant Credit. You look around, you get the best price in town, and you come to Doc Rock, and I'll beat it!
How would you like to save up to 70% on thousands of name brand items from over 100 merchants? Come to the Bazaar, Oklahoma Bazaar, a new concept in flea markets where almost everything under the sun is under our roof. Plus, this weekend, Oklahoma Bazaar introduces outdoor vendors. There's just as much fun outside as in. Bazaar, it's Oklahoma Bazaar. Open Saturday and Sunday from 9 to 6 at 42nd and North Lincoln. Oklahoma Bazaar, a new concept in flea markets.
What you're going to need to get started are 6 apples of any kind, 2 oranges, and a lemon. First, you're going to peel and core the apples. Now, you don't have to peel them. I'm actually leaving the skins on here, and I'm also using an apple corer. If you don't have one, just use a knife and be sure to get rid of the core. Now I'm taking all the wedges and cutting them into thirds. They're just easier to deal with that way. Put your apples in a Dutch oven. This is a 3-quart, but you can use up to a 5-quart if necessary. Now you're gonna zest both your oranges and your lemon. Remember, just get the colored part off. You don't want the white underneath, it's bitter. Once you're done, add all the zest to the apples. Just dump it right in there. Now you're gonna juice both oranges and the lemon and add those juices to your pot as well. Now get a spoon and just gently toss them around just so the juice covers everything and the zest is down in there. Next, you're gonna add a 1/2 cup of light brown sugar. Dark brown sugar can be a little bit too strong for this. Just sprinkle it over the top. You don't even have to stir it in. To that, add 1 tablespoon of cinnamon, and a quarter teaspoon of nutmeg. Next, you're going to need a quarter pound of butter. That is one stick traditionally. Cut it long ways twice, then cut those strips into half-inch cubes. Evenly sprinkle the cubes over the top of the apples. Again, you don't have to mix it in. Cover it with a lid, put it in a preheated oven at 350 degrees for 90 minutes. When it's done, this is what you have. Take a whisk and gently start to break up the cooked apples. Keep whisking until you get to the desired consistency that you want. Be careful not to splatter and burn yourself. If you want a smoother applesauce, use an immersion blender like I'm using here to make it even smoother to the texture you want. Transfer the applesauce to a bowl and cover it with plastic wrap and chill it overnight. You can give it a couple of stirs in between then if you want to. The next day, what you have is delicious homemade cinnamon applesauce. Try different combinations of apples like Honeycrisp and Granny Smith or Gala and Macintosh. Every apple has a different flavor, so try different combinations and find the one that works for you. Enjoy! Okay, so it's been about an hour that I left those chops in. They were just going really nice, low and slow, so I left them in there, but I want to show you this first. This is my favorite cast iron pot, my Lodge Dutch oven pot, and these are the black-eyed peas. Really simple. Like I said, you can put herbs or onions or anything you want in there, but I keep it really simple, and they're just nice and delicious. There's a little bit of onion in there that I put in there, or some leek, actually, but these go great with, gosh, just about anything, but I love them with pork chops. Would you look at that? It doesn't get much better than that, okay? The sauce has cooked down a little bit that was in there. You know what? Let me get a fork here out of my drawer. Oh, look at that. You can see the little pork chops in there. But the sauce has cooked down. There's that little bit of a crusty skin on top, which I actually like. Here, let me turn it this way because I don't want it to tip over. You guys see that all right? There you go. And all the little mushrooms in there. Oh, look how tender they are. Here. Let's take some out and put it on our platter, and then we'll try some. Get right in here. Look at them, they're just falling apart. Mmm. Remember, we seared them just a little bit, just to get a little char and stuff on them. And then we put them right in here. I mean, look at that, you guys. That looks wonderful. And of course, we have to taste it, so these are falling right off the bone. Mmm. It's like pork candy. It is so delicious. Now, if you wanted, you don't want to put this pan over a fire, but if you wanted to, you could take this and put a little bit of a slurry in it, you know, a little bit of flour or cornstarch and some water, and put this in a pan and heat it up and make yourself a nice gravy. But I kind of like it like this. It's just a little bit, it's a little looser. This time I usually like a thick gravy, but this is a little looser. So you can kind of do whatever you want with it. All right, that's it. It's time to go eat. Listen, if you love pork chops and applesauce or black-eyed peas or anything about this episode, give it a thumbs up if you would. Leave a comment below. Tell me what your favorite kind of pork chop is. Share the video with a friend and tell everybody about it. I appreciate you watching. I'm gonna go have a little bit. We've got company over tonight, so we're gonna have a nice dinner. Enjoy cooking, have fun. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.